Ging net open.
Shortcut Fight News. Today with karate legend and Dutch old school kickboxing icon Gerard Gordeau. At his sportscenter dojo Kamakura in The Hague in Holland. Hello Gerard, nice to finally meet you. You travel a lot, so thanks for having me. Gerard, along with your brothers Al and Nico, you own the dojo Kamakura in The Hague. When did you start this?
No, we start karate in 74. And then after a while, we think we can do it by ourselves. And then we start our dojo in 1981. But it was in a gymnastic hall. And but we want like a Japanese, a real own dojo. And then we start in 83. And then we find out that this place was a very good place to start, and then that we do.
It's this location, eh?
This location, yeah.
And what is the meaning of Kamakura?
The meaning of Kamakura is to develop people to try to find their border. Some people get champion of our club, some people champion of find the quality of the people by themselves. And then we try that develop that they can be champion of their own thing.
Yeah.
Not only world champions, because other people are is also important. But some people come up and they're a world champion. Yeah, we have a lot of world champions in this school.
Yeah, this I wanted to ask you. What is the biggest accomplishments of Kamakura?
That we still exist. And I don't care the names or people what's coming here or leaving, but that we still exist and that we protect the things of the martial arts, like traditional karate, kickboxing.
Because all the big names have trained here, right?
Yeah, a lot of people are sitting in our gym to help them. Some trainers ask to me, can you say it on the other way that they understand what he means? But we have the same goal. He have to be the best of their style, like Rico was here.
Okay.
Ernesto Hoos, Hippolyte, Musit. Maybe I forgot names, but I don't care. But Musashi was here, Bob Schreiber, Ernesto Hoost, Irma,
a lot,
Peter Arts.
Almost everyone, I think.
Everybody we help people to develop and then they get the best of the world. And when I look at the television and see them, I think I do a little proud of that. I make a little stone to help them.
Yes, much respect for that. You have a very large martial art resume. Can you tell us your biggest accomplishments in the sports?
I think the most important thing what I get was the first UFC. I do before that pro wrestling, wrestling, free fights. My heart is karate because it is traditional respect for somebody, for the sports. But the most thing I do was the UFC. Then, because everybody say, I'm the best. I do this. No, boxing is the best. Wrestling is the best. And they find out in America to do, okay, how we can say this is the best thing on that day. Because day later, maybe judo win. But on that day, the Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu win. Because on that time, on that day, they were the best. Yes.
You are the 1991 world champion Sawat and holder of the Dutch champion Kyokushin karate title for 8 consistent years.
Yes,
that is also a very big accomplishment.
Yeah, but I like what I do, and if you like it, you can continue. If you don't like it, stop.
You have to love it.
Yeah.
You run an international karate organization together with Pebbles.
Also, yes.
And teaches at camps and seminars worldwide.
Yeah.
Can you tell us more about the seminars?
We try to find one line to protect the Japanese culture, the karate culture. Of course, there are more things like MMA now and Jiu-Jitsu. It's from the old, but in the old days, it's traditional. But we developed it so good. that the people in other countries don't have that information, because all the big fighters are from Holland or they train in Holland, and they have not the time now to bring that to other countries. And I'm stopping with fighting, but I have the knowledge, and we bring it over that the other people can also develop the things, and not only traditional like a book, but there are more things in the world that you can make a combination of.
So your goal is to develop the people?
Not the people, because it is like soccer. It is not play soccer with the leather ball anymore. Now we have Ronaldo. They are so quick and so good. Messi is so good, so quick. But if you make it in our time, we have, yeah, some people. You cannot. Compare with that. It is so developed through the good trainers from Holland.
Really?
Yeah, we are the best in the world.
Really?
Yeah.
And what kind of seminars do you give?
Because I do everything, like wrestling, judo, wrestling, BJJ, karate, kickboxing, Safat, and I can make the combination of that. And now I can show the people, don't stuck in one thing, but there is more. And I show them what's kickboxing, I show them what is jiu-jitsu, and don't bite each other. But the knowledge of the people say, no, you can do only karate, the rest is nothing. No, that time we are...
You have proved that you can do more disciplines.
Yeah, but I'm the only one.
You are unique, eh?
Yes.
You have how many disciplines? You are 7.
Yes, and more, but world champion in 7 disciplines. Yeah. And other people are very good in one discipline, and they are very good in it. But I'm the only one who make the things that I'm, yes. Because I want to know how it is to do other things.
You're curious, eh?
Yes, really? Yeah. I want to know why the people are better than me in that kind of stuff. And then I train and understand what they do. And I'm lucky that I'm world champion.
Because you are very fit.
Yes.
You're very fit.
Yeah, we train not on the level of the fighters anymore, but we train every day with I train every day with a guy who come 90 years ago here. He's from Armenia. His name is Misha. He do everything, and when I'm gone to the country, he take it over. Yeah.
We will talk to Misha in a little bit. You run an international karate organization, Olympics.
Yeah, yeah. But the organization we do with a board. That's one guy who's very good in Kenpo and Chinese Kung Fu, and also Kyokushin. He's third dan. He lives in the south. He can do everything in the south. We have one guy in the middle. That's in Katwijk. That's the champion. He's 8 times world champion, Kyokushin. And me, and we have a board now that we can talk about Facebook is very good, internet very good, but we have also good fighters to young guys who can. I don't kick high anymore. I ask give you a high kick, you have to do it like this. Yeah, and we have a good board now, and the organization is still growing and growing, because we are open, honest, but not a democracy.
Yeah.
No.
And what is the name of the of these seminars? Is it Kamakura?
No, the Kamakura is the name of our dojo. We have many dojos. One in Delft, one in Katwijk, yes. One in Greece, one in Russia, one in Italy, one in Latland, one in Riga. And they are also the name of Kamakura, like a franchising. And the organization is International Budokai.
International Budokai, that's a seminar.
Under that name we do the seminars, yeah.
Before the K1, there was Saidokan Karate.
Saidokan.
It's
yes.
A karate kickbox combo. Since you also practice this discipline, can you tell us more about the forerunner of K1?
When we do karate, Mr. Ishii is the boss of the K1, the former, and he wanted to do something new. because everybody knows what's kickboxing, everybody knows what is this, what is that. And he tried to find out in Japan to a combi to make it commercial for the rest of the world. And then Peter Smith, Robbie Kaman and me go to the tournament, and you have to do 3 rounds karate. When there is no winner, you have to do 2 rounds kickboxing. That's the reason they ask Robbie Kaman. But Robbie Kaman didn't before karate. Dus he was beat up in the karate style, because he's not a karateka. It's normal, because he's a kickboxer. And they find out, okay, we have to change something, because the big names of Holland don't come to that tournament, because you have to do 3 rounds Kyokushin karate. And the kickboxer don't like that, because Kyokushin is for real men. And then he changed something and he make it 5 rounds kickboxing. And then I don't like that, because I'm in my heart, I'm Kyokushin karate. And I said to Ishii, no, I don't come anymore. The new people have to come. And then they ask the new generation of kickboxing. Ernesto Hoos, Peter Arch, Sam Schild, and then developed. But 5 rounds, three minutes. All the good fighters from Holland can do that. But the fat guys from America or other countries, they don't can stand 5 rounds. And then they change it to 3 rounds. But all the people come there, 16 fighters, 8 fights on one day, are from Holland or train in Holland. And then they say, yeah, it looked like a Dutch party. Because Ernesto Hoos win. Next year, Arch, next year Schild, and Remy, and Branko, but they train here. And they said, okay, we have to change it. And then come the flags, and they come from Suriname, from Morocco, from Italy, from whatever. And they change it because they make it very commercial sports for the fighters. And it's very good. That's it. Everybody wants to see it. And the normal people who are sitting with the Coca-Cola and the popcorn see, hey, this is kickboxing. And it's good.
And this was in...
Yeah, in the 80s,
90s. Of course, you are foremost known internationally for your fight in the first televised Ultimate Fighting Championship UFC 1, where you defeated the 400-pound sumo wrestler Taila Tula in 93. Yeah. How many teeth got punched out?
There are 2 out, one in the audience, and the parts of the other teeth are sitting in my feet. Yeah, yeah. And I have the hospital take it out. It's better than I take it out, and I can do it on eBay now. But shit happens.
Oh my God! Do you still have a scar or?
No. I eat healthy.
You eat healthy. Of course, there's another question I have to ask you, because it always comes back to this controversy. The controversy around your UFC debut and the Roman salute.
Yeah, it comes from Rome. That's true. But if you do Safat, like Ernesto Hoos and me, you have to make a salute on the traditional boxing France Safat way. And then you have to do greet like the Romans. Van gij die zullen sterven, groeten nu. And some guy, it's 2000 years old, it comes from the Buddhists from Indonesia, from India. And in Japan, they have also the culture that it is imbalance of that. But some guy make 80 years ago, a combination of that, and everybody think that we do or think somebody else. But if you make your homework, you can do it. This is a French salute for Safat.
And for the viewers, what is Savate exactly?
Savate is box française. It looks like kickboxing, but there are very strict rules. There's no low kicks with the shin. It's not allowed. No knees. No spinning back fist. If you do that, you can do it. Say it is kickboxing. If you do elbows to the face, it is Thai boxing. If you take something out, or if you put something extra, you cannot wear that name. you do Safat and you have to be strict orders and the rules.
So the Roman salute
is the traditional French salute for Box de France.
For the Sabbath.
And they call it Safat.
So it had nothing to do with Hitler.
No, he make a combination of that. If you make that crude and you say something, yeah, then you think because you are stupid and don't make your homework, that you know it is not that salute, but something else. What 80 years ago, but it's very stupid because my family is a part of Jewish. Strange. The Gordeaux is from the Huguenots. They want to kill us, not us, but our family many years ago, and they come to Holland with the French Huguenots.
You also have a Japanese sign for balance on your upper arm, the
swastika. Swastika.
Swastika. Which is also a symbol for a neo-Nazi.
Yeah, it's 80 years ago, but 2000 years ago it was from India. This a Buddhist, and they used it in Japan. And I take Japanese tattoos. I have Japanese tattoos. This is a story, and a part of that is. But you can look to the other side; it's better.
You can show your tattoos later on. So it has nothing to do with the Hitler side.
Make your homework. Look to the history. It is Buddhist from India, and it go over to Japan.
And on top of that, you have Jewish roots, so also, there's no way that you would even consider to...
No, but I don't want to defend myself about it. Read books, make your homework.
At least now we are clear on the subject and finish this subject. Okay. In 1994, you were cornman for UFC 2, participants Remco Pardul and Freek Hameke.
Yes.
Why did you stop cornering?
I talked with the organizer, meneer... Art Davy, I see him 2 months ago, and they said, you are real Jewish. He's a Jewish guy, Art Davy, funny guy. And they said to him, you are a greedy Jewish man. He said, why? He said, you want to be back in the second one, but you pay nothing, or less in that. It was not in balance, and I don't like it when it's a balance. And when there's a balance, it's okay, but they offer me something, and I said, no, I bring my students, it's better for this time. That's the reason I say no.
Okay, and what is your opinion about the UFC these days?
It is so good now. This commercial, very good. It is on the scale of the stock market. It is on there for billions. The fighters are very developed. The style of lightweight, middleweight, heavyweight is now good. They have more champions. It is commercial, very good, and they have also. Good fighting money for that.
Good salaries, huh?
Yeah.
Big salaries. I want your opinion about our top fighters from Holland.
Like the top fighters from Holland, yeah, they are good. They are the best of the world. I don't want to call names, but we have the best fighters of the world, and also the best trainers. But not the best system for the things what we have to do in Holland. They protect in Hungary, France, Germany, Japan. They have a good system to protect the systems in the martial arts. But in Holland, it's still bullshit. Yeah.
And your opinion about the big events these days and all kinds of new rules, like the bare knuckle fighting, kickboxing with MMA glove at ONE FC and the stand-up MMA and fusion?
Yeah, stop the bullshit. Stop that bullshit. It is not a circus. Keep it traditional. Do K1 rules, or do kickboxing rules, or do Thai boxing rules, or do Kyokushin rules, or do wrestling rules. But don't say, I do it already to find out how it is. We do tag team, or we do this. But stop it. Keep it clear and traditional. And the government. A part of the government can say, hey, this is not allowed, this is not allowed. But don't cancel everything, because it is not good.
Mix it up. But Cops doesn't like it either. So just leave it traditional.
Yeah, yeah. But he's a traditional wrestler, and then it's okay, because his mind is traditional wrestling.
And how about Murat Buzini? He did train with you in the days.
Yeah, I have many fighters here, and they take their life and they go marry their children, they go living somewhere else. And that is their opinion. Yeah.
He is fit and he's in training. What advice can you give him to make his return to the ring?
Go back to your own weight. And then try to find out and do kickboxing. Don't fight, but do kickboxing.
Yes,
he's the best kickboxer in the world, but he's not the best fighter in the world. But people want to know and see fighters like two bulls. They like it, but they don't have the knowledge of the martial arts kickboxing, because he's a very clear kickboxer, but he's not a fighter.
So you say your advice is for him to go back to 85 kilograms?
85, yeah, something like that.
To his former weight?
Yeah, and then he can move and use what he can in 100%. Now we have to do 20% what is not like, is fighting. And it's not, there's not on a t-shirt, it's in the books, but not for him.
Not okay.